Hi folks, this is David Kwan here. I suppose that since I'm a resident here in New York City, it's kind of natural that I look at news, local news, and kind of focus in on that. And there has been kind of a lot of history happening, you know, around the country and whatnot. And one of the historic things that happened in New York City just recently is this kind of the vote that the City Council, the Rent Control Guidelines Board, had on increasing rent prices. This is a pretty historic thing considering this hasn't really happened before, but the city voted 7 votes favoring and 2 votes opposing. They decided to freeze rent increases. So I was looking at the language of that, was like, wait, what does that mean? It basically just means that there will be no rent increases for rent stabilized apartments, and just kind of the rent price will stay the same. And kind of the lot of housing activists and affordable housing kind of people who are rallying for that, you know, this was like a pretty victorious moment, which to me, you know, I agree, it's a pretty historic moment and it's really exciting. But at the same time, that this is a victorious moment is also kind of concerning to me, that the fight for affordable housing, you know, has been such a losing battle, losing war, that this is like such a victorious moment. The other thing that was also a really big thing was the you know, the increase in rent of kind of the deregulated rent prices or market price. I think was something, I might not be accurate in how I'm affording it, but one of the other rent increase was only to 2%, which is very like a historic low. It's never been increased by that low of an amount before. And I mentioned this because it's a really important thing to consider when looking past the past 40 years, the past 4 decades, since New York City has established something like, you know, SROs and rent stabilized and apartments and rent control apartments. The price of rent increases has always outpaced the price of wage increases or salary increases. You know, people don't make enough money, and yet everything, the price of everything has risen, especially rent prices. The affordability of housing is no longer really affordable in this city anymore, and people have to like come up with really weird, creative ways to continue living in New York City and not be homeless. And so I think I do agree with, you know, the housing activists. This is really pretty historic, significant news that there was this like no rent increase in rent stabilized apartments. I think that's great, but I'm hoping that it's just a trend or one step towards a better future here in New York City. Because this can't be it, right? The fight for affordable housing in the past 4 decades and longer has been a losing one. And, you know, this one tiny victory kind of just, you know, this one tiny victory, it barely feels like a victory to me just because of how it has been such a losing battle. We need to create more affordable housing units. People's wages and salaries need to get better. Unemployment has to go lower. And so many other factors that play into this, and the fact that, you know, $2,600 a month is considered affordable housing rent price is ridiculous. You know, who can afford a $2,600 a month rent price, right? No one with minimum wage can afford that. No one. Part, you know, it's hard to be earning, I don't know, $60,000 a year, and to be able to make that rent price. So I just wanted to this news, you know, as someone of you whose social work passion has very been centered around affordable housing, housing rights, and homeless services and homelessness prevention. This is a pretty historic news, but it's one that, you know, it doesn't feel like yay kind of news to me. It feels more like, I mean, it is yay in the sense that, like, wow, so finally, you know, some good news in this arena. But, you know, I'm yearning for, like, more fundamental changes to the system, and this is a system which in which we see the past, just past 8 years or past 5 years, the rate of affordable housing that's been lost in New York City, and also the rate of increase in poverty and homelessness has been just ridiculous. So to turn the tide against that increasing rate, I mean, it's going to require really a fundamental change or the way we do things. I don't know. I mean, that's a pretty deep topic to consider, but that's kind of what I had to say about this news and this topic for now, I suppose. Let me guys know what you think about this, or any questions or comments or whatever. Feel free to leave them below in the comment section, and I'll hope you guys to catch you later. Cheers.